everyone. This is Python Pop, a series of quick videos explaining different Python functions and commands. In this video, I'm going to go over for loops, but more specifically, how to count backwards or how to count by skipping. So let's start with a simple for loop. We're going to say for I in some range, and for the range, let's just go from 1 to 10. And we're going to print out I. So I is going to be a number, and it's going to start at 1, because when we use range, that starting number is inclusive, so it's going to start at 1, but it's going to actually end at 9, because the 10 is exclusive. And you see, there we go, 1 through 9. And it counted by 1s, because that's the default when we use range. So if I want to, let's say, skip and count by 2s, I'm going to say for I in range of 1 to 10, comma 2. That's going to say start at 1, go 2 more than 1, 2 more than that, and so on. So this is going to count by 2s. But since we're starting at 1, obviously it's going to do the odd numbers between 1 and 10, including that 1. So if I want to do the even numbers, I'll just start at 0 as opposed to 1. And there we have it, those even numbers. Now, just as we can count by 2s, we can count by 3s, 4s, 5s, essentially any integer we want. We could also do negative integers. And what a negative number is going to do, so for I in range, now let's think about this. If we're going to use a negative number, that's going to go backwards because it's going to be subtracting from our starting value. So I'm going to actually start at 10, and remember that starting value is inclusive, so it's going to start at 10, and let's go all the way to 1, and we'll do this backwards. So I want to take away 1, so negative 1 from 10, and let's go ahead and print out I. Now you can see, there we go, we're starting at 10 and counting all the way down. And it stops at 2 because remember that second number in our range is exclusive. So it's not actually going to get to 1. So if we wanted this to be more like a blast off, we'll go 10 to 0. That way that 1 is indeed within that. And after this is all said and done, outside of my loop, I'll print blast off. So it's going to go through this loop, 10 all the way down to 1, and then say blast off. And there we go. That's how you use a for loop to count backwards or to skip count. And with that, we wrap up this video. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.